Hi, my name is Brandon Howell, and I handle technical marketing with Intersil's Digital Power Products. Today, I'm going to be talking about PowerNavigator 5.2, specifically our new RailScope feature. To help me demonstrate that, I've got several of our demo boards connected to my PC here. Just going down the line, I have a ZL6105, that's a single-phase digital point-of-load controller. I have a ZL8800, that's a dual-output or a dual-phase digital power controller. And I have a ZL8801. This is a dual phase controller with a built-in current share. So all these boards are connected together via PM bus. And then with our dongle here, this is a USB to PM bus adapter. I have it plugged into my PC. I've already launched PowerNavigator 5.2, and we're looking at our new and improved power map here. Each one of these boxes represents a rail from my connected hardware. I've gone ahead and I've labeled some of these. I've made a hypothetical system where I have an ASIC that has three inputs and then a 3.3-volt auxiliary input down here. So let's go to the RailScope and see how this new feature works. So the RailScope is like a low bandwidth oscilloscope that's been built into PowerNavigator. In real time, it'll plot all the telemetry that we're gathering from all of our digital power supplies via PM bus. On the left-hand side here, I have my different rails. I have the ZL6105, the ZL8801, and then the two outputs of the ZL8800. We've gone ahead and we've color-coded these, just like you'd find on an oscilloscope. And then on the plots here, the different colors correspond to the different supplies. So I'm going to go ahead and turn on the outputs for these rails here. Right now I'm showing the input voltage, the output voltage, the load currents, and the internal temperature of all these four devices. So this is my VIN plot. I have a 12-volt input. This is my VOUT plot. I've got one rail at 3.3 volts, another rail at 1.2, one rail at 1 volt, and another rail at 0.8 volt. This is my current. I have a couple amps load on a few of these devices with my electronic load over here. And then here's my temperature. And you can see as soon as I enable the output, the temperature of these devices will go up by a few degrees because now they're enabled in switching. If I walk down the line here of our RailScope feature, I have these different boxes. As I check and uncheck different features, the scopes here, the RailScope will automatically resize each of these view panes here to take full advantage of your screen real estate. So in this case, I'm just looking at the input voltage. If I just want to look at the output voltage, I can turn that one on and then turn the input voltage off. Now I'm plotting my input voltage over here. With RailScope, you can plot up to four different parameters for four different devices. So in total, that's 16 different parameters collected via PM bus and our dongle. Down here are the controls for the graphing. I can pause the graph. So if I'm looking at something and suddenly my output cuts out and my temperature increases, I can actually pause it. I can look at the scope and see exactly what happened, and then I can play it again. If I want to stop it, I want to stop data collection altogether, I just hit the stop button and that'll stop the data collection until you hit play again. When you hit play, it'll basically start from scratch. We can adjust the update rate. So the update rate is how frequently all these telemetry parameters are being updated by our software. So right now I have it at 100 milliseconds. So each of these telemetry values are being updated every 100 milliseconds. I can make it faster. If I type in 20 milliseconds, you notice that now my display is updating faster because I'm updating all the telemetry values at a faster rate. I can change how many points I display. Right now I'm displaying 5 points. If you look at my scale down here, 1 second per division. So each of these divisions is about 1 second in time. If I want to display fewer points, I can go down to 50, and then I can go back to the maximum of 500. And then as I change how many points are displayed, my time scale down here will also automatically update to reflect that. I can change the plot sizes. So with this little key down here, I can decrease or increase the vertical sizing of my plots. I can do the same thing horizontally. I can decrease or increase the sizing. So this allows me to really adjust the plot size for different screen resolutions, or if I want to look at this and also look at some monitor view on PowerNavigator. I can do that as well. So it's a very flexible interface, and it really allows you to optimize the GUI for different screen real estates and exactly what you want to see from our hardware. The final feature is our logging feature. So all the values we're looking at now can be automatically logged to my computer hard drive. If I enable logging, it collects all the telemetry values that are being displayed, as well as the status bits from each of our regulators. So once I turn on logging, it'll collect that information and it'll save that in an Excel CSV file. So that can be useful if you want to set a system up, you want to let it run, you want to go out to lunch, you want to collect data and then come back and see how the system performed. All that data is going to be visible with our logging feature. You can open up Excel, you can graph that, you can do all the data analysis you want on that at a later time. So that's a quick overview of our RailScope feature. For more information, go to www.intersil.com. For PowerNavigator specific information, please visit www.intersil.com/PowerNavigator.